himself, it must be about as near as you can get to heaven on this earth. It was absolutely outstanding in every sense, and you've had here representatives from every part of Ireland and the United States and Britain and so on. And I was just watching when Paddy was introducing the artist, his knowledge about each artist, where each artist came from and so on. That, I suppose, in a lot of ways is a part of our tradition. The fact that we're so closely linked together, and that gives us a sense of strength, and it gives us hope as well when we're challenged, and that we are challenged, let's be fair about it. Society is changing and the world is changing at a very fast rate. People will say perhaps there have been more changes in the last 20 years than in the previous century. But what was lucky was that Comhaltas at least was rooted and stabilised in time for that challenge as well. And we're not alone. There are so many other great organisations like Conran na Gaeilge, Cumann Na Claisceáil, and all of those bodies. So if at any time we feel just a little bit discouraged, we should remind ourselves that very often is the silent majority, and that's the majority. We depend on those at the end of the day. As well as that, if you want to see the influence that something has on people, I'd be inclined to say to you that we're going to leave here tonight after listening to the music and the songs and the fun that we had here. I think we're going to go away feeling exhilarated. I genuinely do. And I think we're going to come back to Congress tomorrow, which can be very dry and very heavy, but reminding us of why that is happening at the same time. And as you know, Comhaltas today, we discussed it today as well. Comhaltas is now spread throughout the world. And it's spread throughout the world precisely because the people kept the music alive back in the more difficult years. We also made the point today, let's use what we have, and let's use the strength that we have, not for ourselves, but to look outside and see who else might need help. People always need help at a given time. People are always vulnerable. So if we have the opportunity to use the music and the singing and the dancing to help other people, then we're doing, I think, what those who established Comhaltas would want us to do. I always think when you walk through the crowds at Fláchiúil na hÉireann, and you see the tens of thousands of people, all assembling from all over the world, I don't know what goes through your mind when you're walking through the crowds, but I always feel, whether it's daytime or nighttime, and knowing why they've all come to that particular location, I always feel we won at the end of the day. And I also feel that there's an opportunity for us to influence the younger generation. When you were listening to the young musicians here tonight, I'm certain that you felt that that was an example that the music was going to continue into the future. The nation is particularly, I believe, appreciative on the one hand and fortunate to have Sean O'Shea. Sean O'Shea has been around for a good few years, and we go back, I suppose, we won't say how long, Sean, but I remember when I was teaching Cayley dancing all those years ago, and I used to run quite a lot of Cayleys, and Sean used to sing with the Blarney Cayley band back in those days. And we used to bring him to the Tipland Ballroom in Cashel back in those. And I suppose, in fairness, we're talking over a half century. When did you ever hear a voice so strong and so pure after all those years as we heard?
Hey, Mr. O'Shea.
We joined up, I suppose, through Comhaltas, perhaps when he got the Bardic Award first, and then, of course, he got the Ard Dhuibh as well. But the important thing was like he mentioned about Martin Donoghue, it's not hard to get Sean to help. Whenever his diary is free, he'll come and he'll be part of that as well. I'd have to make special mention of Martin O'Donoghue because, again, I can look back at when I was at Martin's wedding all those years ago, and he had brought out, I don't know, was it a record or a CD? I think it was the Free Spirit at that particular time. But Martin is still a free spirit. But really, all the talent that we've had on stage, all the young people that we've had on stage, and you know, when I hear a song about Sarsfield, it tells me something, that deep down in us all, we want to celebrate our history, whether it goes back a long distance or a short distance. But don't ever fool yourselves. Those who might like to revise history, those who might try to intimidate us into forgetting history, there isn't a nation in the world that forgets its history. Always remember that. Because if you ignore your history and you ignore the lessons of the past, what chance have you building for the future? And that's why our history is important. And it's passed on to us very often in our songs. And Seamus Brogan, I must say, God, there was a manliness about that song tonight. I think if you were there at that time, you'd be at the side of Sarsfield, Seamus. I don't want to go through all the artists that we had here tonight, but whether it was a newly composed song, or whether I was delighted to see Morris back. We had a very long chat there for nearly a half an hour earlier, and it was an inspiration to talk to him. But when you saw the master and the student together, it reminded you once again of how we pass on the traditions from one generation to the next. So tonight has been, for me, very special, nostalgic, no doubt about it, it was emotional in every sense of the word. And just let me put a question to you. We're located here in the old Ratdown School. That's what it was when we bought it all those years ago, over 40 years ago. And I still can remember the day that I signed the contract for £47,000 for the building in front and the mews at the back. You may not believe this. When we signed the contract, we hadn't a penny in the bank. That's as true as I'm standing here. But what we did have was we had faith and confidence in Comhaltas. And you can look back in history again. When Padraig Pearse set up Scun Éireann, St. Enda School, he was exactly like Comhaltas. He hadn't a penny in the bank, as the records will show at the time. But what he did have, and he had confidence in the nation to support him when the time came. Everybody who has contributed here tonight, Bernard and Siobhan and all the people behind the scenes, and I know you will feel the same. We're going away tonight with strength. We're going away tonight with determination. We're going away tonight with appreciation. And if you were to go through all the artists that we had here, each and every one has a personal story of their journey which brought them from wherever they were to where they are in music today. And those stories make up a fabric, I believe, that we add to that fabric as time goes on. The Gach Ille Dina, a Bion Shaw, Agashivsha, Loch Deshtofte, then Sko, Le Kuna De, Bermi Bio Arish, Eren Aung Shaw, and Bleen Shakoi. Gramina Bion.
During his time as Director General, in the way he has directed this organisation and has grown it to the force that it is today, you tell us more, not counter. He has done more than any other one among us to make Comhaltas the force it is today, ably assisted by Una. Yeah. Yeah. Very quick word, John Lee and Mick Cantwell, who are expert on sound and lights, Shimani Kunaran, who is the stage manager and did several other jobs as well. Indeed, if I have Shimon by my side, I won't make many mistakes. And then, of course, doing an awful lot of work.